Well, Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Happy Pride. I always think that's so funny to say Happy Pride. I don't know why I think it's funny. Well, this weekend has come around again here in Los Angeles. And here in West Hollywood, just down the street, we observed the LGBTQ Pride Festival and on Sunday the parade. A celebration of community spirit, of diversity, and the rainbow flags will be waving all across town. Today in Tel Aviv, more than 250,000 people gathered to celebrate Gay Pride on the beaches of Tel Aviv, the largest one ever. Rainbow flags with the Magen David, the Star of David, waved proudly through the town, and even a few of our own temple members are there celebrating this year. Gilbert Baker, the creator of the rainbow flag, said this about his creation. The flag is an action. It's more than just the cloth and the stripes. When a person puts the rainbow flag on his or her house or his or her car, they're not just flying a flag, he said. They're taking an action. Tonight on Pride Shabbat, we celebrate with the rainbow flag. It's become a symbol of LGBTQ people and allies everywhere around the world. It is a symbol of diversity, a symbol of equality. By flying the flag, we're acting by sharing our values. It says, we uphold diversity, we uphold freedom, liberation, and equality, and yes, liberty. Gilbert Baker, the creator of the flag, was born in June of 1951 in Parsons, Kansas, the Midwest. He was a sensitive and artistic child. Art was his form of therapy and escape. And according to his biography, Baker suffered a lot while growing up in that conservative state and with his conservative family. He hoped that by being drafted into the United States Army, that would be his escape from the small town that he lived in. But he encountered severe homophobia in the Army in his time in basic training. He opted to become a medic while in the Army, and Gilbert was miraculously stationed in San Francisco. There he found a home as an openly gay man thriving in the counterculture movement of the post-Stonewall era in the early 70s. After completing his military service, Gilbert used his artistic talents in political efforts of the time, creating banners for anti-war protests and pro-gay marches. At the suggestions of friends and colleagues, including Harvey Milk, the San Francisco supervisor, Gilbert began to work on the creation of a new symbol for a gay and lesbian political movement. He sought to replace what was then being used, which was the pink triangle, a Nazi relic from World War II, which was a popular signifier of the time. Baker said this about his creation. In the past, when I thought of a flag, I saw it as just another icon to lampoon. I'd considered all the flag waving and patriotism in general to be a dangerous joke. But that changed for me in 1976. The American Bicentennial Celebration put the focus on the American flag, he said. It was everywhere, from pop art to fine art, from tacky souvenirs and trashy advertising. On every level, though, he said, it functioned as a message. After the orgy of bunting and hoopla surrounding the bicentennial, I thought of flags in a new light, he wrote. I discovered the depths of their power, their transcendent transformational qualities, and I thought of the emotional connection that they hold. I thought how most flags represented a geographical place. They were primarily nationalistic or territorial, iconic propaganda, all things that we questioned in the 1970s. And yet gay people were tribal, individualistic, and a global collective that was expressing itself in art and politics. I knew we needed a flag to fly everywhere. One night, while dancing with his good friend and activist Cleve Jones, who was part of Harvey Milk's entourage and who would go on to found the NAMES Project AIDS Quilt, the idea of a rainbow hit Baker. It was actually from the glint of the light of the disco ball, the light that split into many colors, a rainbow swirling about him on the dance floor that became his inspiration. I didn't even think twice about what the flag would be. A rainbow, it fit us. It comes from nature. It connects all the colors of sexuality and all the diversity of our community, said Baker. Now this is what he wrote about the colors in the flag. Red equals life, orange healing, yellow sunlight, green nature, indigo harmony, and violet was spirit. The rainbow itself, he wrote, is of and from nature to represent a group who are as natural as nature itself. Individual colors, microcosms coming together in one beautiful macrocosm. A symbol that came, as Baker said, torn from the soul of the people for the people. Now in Jewish tradition, the rainbow has very special meaning. A rainbow is a promise by God not to destroy the earth again. The rainbow is a promise of the ongoing relationship between God and humanity. The rainbow is the symbol of the very first covenant that God made with Noah and his descendants, who, according to our tradition, was a righteous man, bedoro tov, in his generation. Another midrashic tradition says that when there are truly righteous people in a generation, there's no need for rainbows, because those righteous people reflect the divine glory. And so in Bereishit Rabbah, it tells us of several generations in which there were such righteous people that no rainbow was ever seen. The generation of King Hezekiah, the era of the men of the great assembly, the generation of Shimon bar Yochai, you know, he was the one that wrote the Zohar, and the generation of Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi. When no rainbow appeared in the heaven, it was the ultimate sign that there lived a person as righteous as ever. And that person was the foundation stone of the earth. The Talmud tells of a story of the meeting between Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi and Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai in Gan Eden, in the Garden of Eden, which is a Kabbalistic term for heaven. Rabbi Shimon asked Rabbi Yehoshua if the rainbow had been seen in his lifetime. Rabbi Yehoshua, so shy, he modestly hid his own greatness by saying that it had. And then Rabbi Shimon said, "Then you are not Ben Levi." When we recite a bracha, a blessing, when we see a rainbow. Did you know that? Whenever you see a rainbow, you're supposed to say a blessing. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, zocher habrit. Praised are you, Adonai our God, source of the universe, who remembers the covenant. Our prayer of seeing a rainbow is to acknowledge that first covenant that God made with Noah, and hence Noah's descendants, all of us. And even the prophet Ezekiel described a vision in which he had seen the divine presence, and it looked like a rainbow in the cloud on a rainy day with a corona around it. This was how the glory of God appeared, and I saw it and fell on my face and heard a voice speaking. Thus the very face of God, according to the prophet Ezekiel, is a rainbow itself. And according to Jewish tradition, the coming of the Messiah will be announced in part with the sign of the rainbow in the heavens. Imagine that, the redemption of the world, the perfection of the universe will come with the sign of the rainbow. This phenomena of light, of refraction of light in water that splits the light into many colors, the colors of the spectrum itself, glorious display of beauty. I think that is what Gilbert had in mind. There's so many messages still around our world that LGBTQ people are ugly, perverse creatures. It wasn't so long ago, less than 50 years, since homosexuality was declared not a psychiatric condition, a mental illness. And though here in our state of California, reparative therapy is banned, it is still legal in many states and in many places around the world, as if gay people need fixing. In the past few years, even as LGBT rights have made progress, let's be honest, we still have a long way to go. We are experiencing now the backlash to marriage equality with renewed vigor. Hate crimes are up, attacks on the trans people, including exclusion from military service, state legislatures saying that LGBTQ people can no longer adopt, allowing discrimination of gay and lesbian people based on individual religious beliefs, the result of the recent Masterpiece Cake Supreme Court case. These are symptoms of an ongoing homophobia that is deeply embedded in our culture. You may feel safe here in West Hollywood, maybe even here in California. It may be easier today for some of our youth to come out younger than we certainly did, but make no mistake, there is plenty of stigma to go around. Plenty of embedded shame, plenty of embedded trauma that still weaves its thread through our communities. Plenty of hate that gets expressed in big and in small ways. The work is not yet done. Liberation is not yet complete. So that rainbow flag has become the symbol of gay pride. Well, that's no small thing. And so the rainbow flag, in all of its beauty, as a symbol of our beauty, our diversity, our wholeness, when waved and displayed, is our act of defiance to homophobia and transphobia. The rainbow flag is our covenant we make with each other that we shall pledge to remain healthy and whole, to support one another, to fight for one another, and to continue to demand that our truth is added to the diversity of human expression of love. The rainbow flag is our symbol of truth that LGBTQ people and our allies shall continue to wave proudly and often to remind ourselves not only, but the world, remind the world at large that the promise contained in that very first rainbow described in Genesis, the rainbow of promise of God to Noah, that promise is a promise of hope and righteousness from which blessings will flow, so that the true colors of the light will enhance and lead our way, so not just this weekend, one weekend a year, but let that flow every day, your true colors shine forth like the rainbow. You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged, oh, I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all and darkness, oh, inside. You make me feel so small, but I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show.
Your true colors are beautiful as a rainbow. Show me a smile then, don't be unhappy, can't remember when I last saw you laughing. If this world makes you crazy, you've taken all you can bear. You can call me up because you know I'll be there. I'll be your true colors shining through. I'll see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors are beautiful like a rainbow. Shabbat shalom, and happy Pride.